Before giving the words to Sinikka Sipilä from the president of IFLA, we will show you a little movie about the subject that has been the line of this meeting. So we show you now a little movie about how libraries can change life. It's not an IFLA film, but anyway, it's very near to the subject we are discussing in this conference. So please have a look.
There is so much coming our way these days. So much information. So many new developments. All asking for so many new skills. We need knowledge. We need jobs. We need time for ourselves and for each other. We need a place to find the resources to learn new skills. To get to know more about what we love. To improve and get ahead. To reach out to loved ones. And to make new friends. These places are already here. In 65,000 locations throughout Europe, welcoming more than 100 million citizens each year. Places that fight unemployment, illiteracy, digital illiteracy, and loneliness. Places near us that connect people and nurture the skilled employees, creative learners, and cohesive communities Europe needs. Places we can't do without. Libraries change lives.
Yes.
There is.
Yes, thank you for showing us this. I think it's very clear that libraries can change life. And in a second, we will see Sinikka Sipilä from the president of IFLA on the stage here. And we thank you very much coming the way to Denmark. I was in Lyon last year at the IFLA conference, where you and your strong presidential theme was strong libraries, strong societies. And your message was very clear. Libraries can change life, as we just seen here in the movie, but I'm sure we all also will hear from you. We signed a declaration, the Lyon Declaration, where that theme was actually the main thing we want to say, tell the world. Namely, that if you learn to read, if you commit yourself to your society, that can change your life. And the place where that can happen, that's in the library. That's one of the places. Of course, there's more, but libraries play a key role to that. But Sinikka, please come up and address us and tell us a little more about IFLA, what you're working with, and how the international family is in libraries. Give a warm welcome to Sinikka Sipilä.
Thank you very much. It's great to be here today. Thank you very much for the invitation to come and speak to you today. I was especially inspired by the theme of this conference because it's really close to my presidential theme, as President already mentioned here. And I would also here like to thank the Danish library community, the IFLA members, for your strong support to IFLA throughout the years. You have been very active there and in big numbers in congresses and very active in committees and so on. We are looking forward to this continuous support from you also in the future. Thank you very much. Okay, thank you. When I first time came to Aarhus in 1997, I was introduced already then to plans of a new library. And yesterday we saw them come true. What a wonderful place it will be for the citizens of Aarhus. I would like to congratulate the city, the leadership and staff of Aarhus Libraries for this great achievement that will act as a pioneer of a new kind of library and experience and development for your citizens here. I'm here on behalf of IFLA. I would like to say some words of that. IFLA is the International Federation of Library Associations and Institutions, representing the interest of library and information sector and their users also. We have members in nearly 150 countries, 1,400 members, libraries, library associations, and individuals. And we are a truly global organization. And the president of this organization chooses, each of them chooses a theme that will best describe his or her goals during the presidency. I have chosen my theme, Strong Libraries, Strong Societies, because I truly believe that libraries exert an impact on society by fostering equal opportunities and providing access to lifelong learning and education, to research and innovation, to culture and recreation for all. In so doing, libraries can contribute to building stronger libraries, communities and societies. My theme also supports IFLA's strategy and key initiatives, and one of them, the latest ones, was mentioned already by the president, the Lyon Declaration on Access to Information and Development. And the core message is that libraries promote development by empowering people with many skills. The other important document is the IFLA Trend Report, which was launched 2 years ago and is still valid. It points and looks at the society, the emerging and changing in digital information environment where libraries work and are affected by those trends. And we must be aware of them and prepare to keep our libraries strong also in the future. When I planned my theme together with my colleagues, I was inspired by the work IFLA is doing, especially on different projects and initiatives where libraries promote development. Because this is the core of my theme, libraries promoting development. My theme also springs of our own experiences here in the Nordic countries, especially in Finland, which I know best. All these countries can be regarded nowadays strong and active library countries. But it wasn't always that way. At least Finland was a poor agrarian country still some 50 years ago. Today it's a modern knowledge-based society like all other Nordic countries. And what has made this happen? There are many factors, but I'm sure the education system and open access to information in public libraries, in other libraries, within the extensive library networks in our countries, has and the active development work in libraries, as well as the strong support from library associations, have resulted in the strong status of libraries that libraries enjoy currently in Nordic countries. For example, in Finland, we had a survey in 2010, and 70% of respondents there stated that libraries had improved their quality of life. It had made a difference in their life. And also, libraries are recognized as exerting a major impact on literacy as measured by the results of Finnish students in the PISA evaluation by OECD, even if they have changed a little in last years, but they are still quite good. As the theme of this conference proposes, libraries can change lives. Libraries support education and literacy, that these are the pathways which have allowed individuals to rise in the societies. And that was clearly expressed also in writings the Finnish Library Association and other associations gathered some years ago in Finland from library users on the topic how libraries had changed their lives, the topic of this conference also. And we also published a small booklet on that topic. And I must say that when I then read 2010 those stories, it was then when I started, not then, I wasn't aware of my IFLA career and my IFLA presidency at that time, but I was so impressed by them that when I started to think about my theme, I remembered those stories. And they were there, maybe the main source for my theme, because I learned there how much libraries can impact people's lives. There were many heartwarming stories, for instance, from elderly people who had lived in remote areas in their youth and childhood, in small villages with nearly no services there, but they happened to have a library there in the school. Normally it was at the school. And that was something very special to them. They had found it as a source for knowledge, recreation, comfort and social place, as well as, what is most important for me, as an eye-opener or gateway to the world from that small village and to new possibilities and opportunities in their life. And that, I think, is the most important role for libraries. One story was from an author who described how the library had been his university. Without it and its dedicated staff, he wouldn't have achieved what he has and is today. And what is particularly touching, he especially thanked the branch librarian who had been so helpful and supportive. Actually, this librarian had made him believe in his talents and encouraged him to become an author. There were also stories from younger people who had seen the library as a social place where they could meet with friends, do their schoolwork, and as well as meeting with their dates. In fact, libraries seem to have a major role as a neutral, friendly environment where human relations can start and evolve, as we saw in the film also. So libraries have a great impact on people's happiness. And as we know, according to surveys, that Denmark is one of the happiest countries in the world. You must have obviously done a great work in your libraries here. My experiences during my presidency have also strengthened my belief in the impact of libraries in society. For instance, that young boy here, he is an active user of a library in near Windhoek, in Katutura, which is a very big informal settlement. And people are living in very, very poor conditions there, without any services, without nearly nothing. But there is a library. And those children come there in big numbers every day. It's full every day. It's not a very big library, but there are spaces and it's full. There's a playground for small children. For instance, the parents come there with their children. It's really a heart of that community, and it makes a difference in people's lives. So how do we define strong libraries? Perhaps their strength can be defined by their mission. Professor R. David Langs from Syracuse University, USA, has suggested that the core mission of libraries, public and otherwise, is to create informed and active citizens. And the job of the library is to meet the needs of the community members, not just the materials. And from my perspective, to accomplish this goal, our libraries must be seen by the user communities as welcoming, safe places with adequate and space and catalogues staffed by competent personnel and helpful personnel, places which provide access to up-to-date resources relevant to their needs, including digital contents. And here, library associations have a very important role to play too, because they can advocate on national and local levels for libraries and IFLA on the international level for their better development, for better resources, for better awareness among funders to support libraries. And what is a strong society like? It stands to reason that strong societies consist of informed citizens who actively participate in the life and activities of their community. For me, a strong society is a strong civil society. Strong libraries that can meet the educational, information, cultural, social needs of their users can promote and support participation and involvement in a democratic society. Active citizenship represents the basis of a democratic society, and therefore it's essential and that information and knowledge, as well as the modern tools of citizenship, should be made available universally through libraries. I find this connection between libraries and civil society very strong, as libraries are part of civil society. Nancy Cranich from Rutgers University, USA, has written about libraries and civil society. She states that as libraries serve in prepare citizens for a lifetime of civic participation, they also encourage the development of a civil society. They provide the information and the opportunities for the dialogue that the public needs to make decisions about common concerns. As community forums, they encourage active citizenship that renew and invigorate communities. When people are better informed, they are more likely to participate in policy discussions in which they can actively and freely communicate, in which they can freely communicate their ideas and concerns. Libraries provide the real and virtual spaces for the members of the community to exchange ideas which are fundamental to democratic participation and civil society. And Aarhus Library was such a great example we saw yesterday. All the spaces there for interaction, activities, discussions, debates. And this is exactly what I mean by my theme, strong libraries, strong societies. And this has been also involved in the vision for Helsinki City Library, for the new one, which will be opened in 2018. The library is a place full of new ideas. By sharing information, knowledge, and stories, we are creating a new civil society together. I would like to conclude with inviting you all to my second president's meeting in Istanbul in June, which has titled The Art of Transforming Libraries, because it's very important we discuss on that theme in all libraries, how to keep our libraries strong also in the changing environment. And that's why we have to be ready to transform our services, our working habits, our thinking. And we can start, for instance, in Istanbul at my meeting. And in today here, I have seen the program, you have very good topics for the rest of the day to discuss about. Thank you very much.
Once again, thanks to Sinikka Sipilä. What, and one more time, you have inspired me, and I hope everyone else, and given a little, given us an opportunity to look into the international family. We are very grateful that you have joined us here and told us about your great work.